Alright guys, so we've been spending a lot of time talking about nucleophiles and leaving groups, but sometimes when you look at your reaction, you're going to see some weird letters at the bottom, like you might see DMF or DMSO or even just water, and you're wondering what kind of role does that compound play in this reaction. In fact, you might be getting freaked out like, I don't know what kind of reaction I have because I don't recognize this molecule. And I'm here to tell you that that is usually going to be the solvent, okay? If you see something at the bottom of your arrow, that's usually where the solvents go, and that's what we're going to discuss in this page. So let's go ahead and get started. So solvents are basically inert compounds. That's the whole point. They can't react, okay? The whole point of a solvent is that it's something that serves as a medium for you to run a reaction in. And even though they are, you know, they do have impacts on reactions to some degrees, what we're going to find in this course is that the impact of your nucleophile and leaving group is much, much more important than the impact of your solvent. So typically when we see solvent questions, it's going to be in the form of a conceptual style question where it will talk about what type of solvent is favored, but it's not going to be a mechanistic question where it will actually determine the type of reaction that you have. Okay, so I just wanted to let you know, just underline this part, that these solvents are rarely going to affect the outcome of a written reaction. So many times we're just going to neglect them. We're not going to look at them too much. All right. So overall, if we're looking at a chemical reaction, because I know this is new to a lot of you guys, what we're going to do is we're going to see some kind of reagent or some kind of starting product. Okay. And then you're going to see an arrow. And that arrow is going to have two compounds usually. It's usually going to have something at the top, and that's usually the reagent. That's usually the active substance, okay? Then at the bottom, typically you'll see the solvent. The solvent is the thing that, like I said, does not react, but just serves as a place for the reaction to occur, okay? Now, what I'm saying right now isn't a written rule. So that means that there are going to be times where maybe if you have a two-step reaction, that you'll have the on top of the arrow is one of the parts, and the second part is at the bottom, and both are reactive, okay? But really what all I'm trying to say is that many times you're gonna see reactions with solvents in them, and really it's mostly your job to ignore them. It's mostly your job to say, hey, I'm not gonna really pay attention to this part, I'm just gonna pay attention to what Johnny said was really important, which was the nucleophiles and the leaving groups.